therapies develop the hypothesis. Before that, the researcher must know the usage of certain important terms in research. What are they? First of all, concept, construct, variables, proposition, then hypothesis, derivative. What do you mean by concept? In this session, we focus on the role of theory in research. Theory is defined as a set of systematically interrelated concepts, definitions, and propositions that are used to explain and predict a particular phenomenon. The theory is derived from a Greek word, theoria, which means contemplation or speculation. Theory not only explains or predicts a phenomenon, but also specifies the causal relationship among variables. Causal relationship means cause and effect relationship between independent and dependent variables. For example, standard of living of a family is dependent on income, size, and lifestyle. This is a theory which provides a basis for studying consumers' buying behavior and making the appropriate marketing strategies that is developed by market manager. What are the concepts? First of all, in this example, the basic unit of theory building is a concept. Standard of living of a family, that is treated as a concept. How to measure this concept? By using operational definitions. Operational definition means the concept convert it into theoretical observable manner. The act of providing a measure of concept is used as variable or indicators. We call it as operational definition. Then measurement provide the basis for more precise estimates of degree of relationship between concepts. There are two types of concepts. But in the social science research, there is no relevance of classification of this type of concept. But we realize the meaning of types of concept. There are two types of concept. One is postulational concept and other one intuitive concept. What do you mean by postulational concept? For example, gymnasium. It is used as a physical education aspect in our country. But in Germany, it is a combination of high school and junior college. That means different meaning in different context. The postulation concept is mainly developed through imagination and intellection. Next type of concept is intuitive concept. It has particular meaning. Meaning is never changed by people, those who are use it. For example, the color related with black. Black color, the meaning is abstracted from the wider and empirical studies. There are two forms. The researcher reaches that particular abstraction of idea through sensation or introspection. The next is construct. What do you mean by construct? Construct is a concept, but it is not directly observable. Constructs are more general than concept. For example, IQ of an individual. IQ of an individual, not directly observable one. But the researcher used different indicators, especially mark. Mark is used as an indicator for the purpose of measuring that particular concept. That we call it as construct. The next is social class. Another example, social class. Social class is recognized only after measuring. It is not directly observable. The personal income is treated as an indirect measure of social class. Under this, the personal income is identified through monthly salary obtained for a particular individual. That used as a direct measure of the indicator.
I am going to discuss a new term, variable, in research. What do you mean by variable? Variable means a quantity or quality that varies. It may change from person to person or group to group or within the person over time. Control of variables. There are a lot of variables we can be used for analyzing in the particular research.
For example, eating ice cream that leads to fever. Ice cream is independent variable. Fever is treated as dependent variable. Lot of causes leads to the effect on the other variable. Cause is independent variable. It is also known as manipulated variable. Then the effect of the other, that means dependent variable. This dependent variable is measurable one that can be measured by using different statistical tools. Then one of the important other variable is moderating variable. Moderating variable is also known as mediating or intervening variable. That can be discussed in the later examples. The consumer's attitude towards healthy lifestyle could impact their organic purchase intention. In organic food study, consumer's attitude towards healthy lifestyle could impact their organic purchase intention. This is the statement. In this statement, independent variable and dependent variable can be identified. One is independent variable and the other one dependent variable. Can you identify these variables? Consumer's attitude is treated as independent variable. Organic purchase intention, that is dependent variable. And these independent and dependent variables are going to a particular relation. The same way, we are using the moderating variable. One of the moderating variable in connection with the dependent and independent variable, that are income and education level. Income and education level of the buyer. That means when a person or a buyer intends to purchase the organic food, according to the awareness of the organic food is leading to healthy lifestyle, automatically that the variable taken as mediating variable, that is education. Then income. Income is also treated as a moderating or mediating variable. That is the consumer attitude to buy a particular organic food item, that is depend on the income. Income is the factor. Income leads to purchase intention. These two variables are not directly influences, but it is connected with the independent variable for predicting buyer's attitude towards purchasing behavior. The next is mediating variable. What do you mean by mediating or intervening variable? These variables are known as variable explain how the relationship between independent and dependent variable happens. Moderating variable means that variable change the strength of an effect or relationship between independent and a dependent variable. Next is related with the organic food study. Consumers' attitude towards healthy lifestyle could impact their organic purchase intention. Among these statements, independent variable is consumer attitude, then moderating variable, income level and education level, dependent variable is purchase intention. The next is related with the consulting firm. In an example, the consulting firm management is looking at the option of introducing flexi time work schedule with an intention there will be an increase in the productivity of each individual worker, especially women employees. There are two important concepts we have to be going to discuss. Flexi work timetable. Flexi work timetable. Among women workers, then leads to productivity. Flexi timetable. Flexi work timetable leads to productivity. Which one is dependent variable and which one is independent variable? Flexi time schedule introduced by a firm with an intention to increase the productivity level. Intervening variable is that variable used to explain the relationship between variables. It is temporal and occurrence follows independent variable and it precedes the dependent variable. That means the management of the particular company introduce this particular variable, that is flexi work timetable. After that, after introduction of the flexi work timetable,
among women employees increases the productivity level among the employees. That means this is treated as a particular variable intervening that is leading to productivity increases, that is dependent variable. Some variables treated as extraneous variable, that are any variable not intentionally studying in our experiment or research. For example, a good speaker can increase the level of understanding among students on a particular topic. This is a proposition. What is our assumption behind good speaker, better the speaker, better the understanding level? Some moderating variables are there. One is sound regarding about the room, soundproof room, then air conditioned room, good light and facilities. That we treated as sound environment or good environment, sound environment or good environment, then good speaker. These are the two variables leading to other variable. That variable we treated as dependent variable, increase the level of understanding among students. That means sound environment or good environment leading to increase the level of understanding, that mediating. Sound environment is treated as mediating variable together with independent variable, that is good speaker, lead to increase the dependent variable understanding level among students. Next is, but it happens different situation. Suppose sound environment is there, good speaker is there, but what happens? Maybe decrease the level of understanding level. It is due to extraneous variable, that is not come under the situation of independent and dependent variable. Some variables are outside the system, that be known as extraneous variable. These extraneous variable may be the student is worried about the exam, or he or she not well to the particular situation to catch the important matters discussed by the speaker. Automatically, it also affects the understanding level of the student, maybe decrease or increase due to different factors. All these factors we call it as extraneous variable. Age is numerical variable. Then qualitative variable, taken as example of gender. Gender expressed in terms of male and female. This is qualitative variable. How can be expressed these variable into different categories for unit of measurement? Quantitative variables are classified again interval and ratio scale. Interval and ratio scale. Qualitative scales are divided into two: nominal and ordinal scale. What do you mean by interval and ratio scale, and what do you mean by nominal and ordinal scale? Nominal variables, that is only naming or identifying the particular individual. For example, in a running competition, numbers assigned to runners may be first, second and third. These numerals are used for identifying the first individual, second individual or third individual. The same way, alphabetic letters, alphanumeric symbols can be used. Alphabetic letters A, B, C and D, used for identifying that particular individual. But in the case of ordinal scale data means ranking. The performance of the A, B, C and D, performance of A and performance of B, performance of C and performance of D are different. Who will win that particular game? Which one reach into the third place and which one reach into second place and first place? These are identified by using the measurement using ordinal or ranking scale. The next is related with the interval scale and the ratio scale. An individual got the point. How much point the person secured in that particular game may be 15.2 or 16.7 or 16.5. These are denoted as the ratio scale. But the interval scale means the person requirement of that ranking come under the category. For example, 10 to 20, then 20 to 30, 30 to 40. The value lies in between these particular intervals. These are called interval scaling. Nominal scale means the value or coded value, alphabetic or numerals are used for indicating or identifying the particular individual or the respondent in the particular category of study. But in the case of ordinal category, it is also known as ranking style. Suppose the A secure the third place. Suppose B secure the first place and C secure the second place. Who will win in according to their preference or ranking or ordinal scale? Then again, the interval data is also known as continuous nature. Ordinal data and numeral data, nominal data, ratio data, it also classified into different category. Interval data is also known as continuous scale. Continuous scale means the value lies in between two important integers, that is 1 and 2. In between 1 and 2, the value lies in 1.2. Example, height of an individual and weight. These are continuous probability data. Then discrete variable. Discrete variable means the value, absolute value, that is discrete variable, the value 15, age of a particular individual 15, the number of students in a particular class is equal to 20. These are discrete numerical variables. But there are number of variables can be identified with the help of quantitative and qualitative statements, quantitative interval and ratio scale, again divided into continuous and discrete, nominal and ordinal, both are qualitative and categorical variables. Again, nominal data used for identifying the particular individual or respondent for the purpose of analysis. In the case of ordinal data, we use numbers in the performance level, ranking, first place, second place and third place. Then interval data means the value, the performance value lies in between upper level and lower level. In the case of ratio, how much is the performance level that should be secured by particular individual after performance? That point, absolute point of value or numerical value is denoted as ratio. Then again classified into continuous data and discrete data. Continuous data means it is lies in between two intervals. That is 1.2 is one of the example. Then discrete variable is number of students in a particular class, that is 20. Binary variable. Binary means two classification only. It is used for identifying 0 or 1. For example, are you satisfied with a particular product? Yes or no? The options are quantified in terms of 1 or 0. Then this is also known as dichotomous variables. There are only two options identified for the purpose of projecting your response. As a researcher, that is in the questionnaire, set of questions he put for the purpose of collection of data, the researcher set the question in a form of binary. That is two options only under this category. Next is dummy variable. Dummy variable is also used for analysis. For example, it is mainly used for recording categorical variable in the series of binary variable. Marital status. Marital status, there are two options. First of all, married and unmarried or single. Unmarried or single. These are the two options we set aside for the purpose of collection of data. But in the case of
married again given certain classification, that is widow, then divorce and separated. And these three classifications are created as a dummy variable. A dummy variable, it record categorical variable in a series of binary variable. For example, marital status of an individual, that should be coded as married and unmarried. Again, among the married options, we provided three options again: widow, then divorce, separated. These variables can be identified by using the value provided here, one option and two option as a coded variable. Then third one is endogenous variable and exogenous variable. Endogenous variable means these variables are also come under the particular finding cause and effect relationship together with independent variable. Endogenous variables are those variables happening together with independent variable, and its effect directly influences on the dependent variable. But in the case of exogenous variable, exogenous variables are those variables, it is not come under the particular independent variable and it has no direct relation, but it is confounding relationship with the dependent variable. That is, not directly influences, but it is affected indirectly. Then fifth variable named as latent variable. Latent variable, for example, intelligence. Intelligence of a person that can be identified with the direct, that cannot be identified directly. Intelligence of a person cannot be identified directly, but can be identified with the help of an IQ test conducted by the researcher. After conducting this IQ test, intelligence of a person can be identified higher level or medium and lower level. These three options can be identified later. So the latent variables are those variables, that is hidden variable in the particular survey of research, but the manifest variable are those variables used as an indicator. Here IQ test is treated as an indicator for identifying the intelligence of an individual. At which level? At higher level, medium level and lower level. These are the variables also we used under research. One is binary. There are only two options are given, yes or no. We are using different numerals for the purpose of coding, maybe 0 or 1 or 1 or 0. Dummy variable means the recording categorical variable in a series of binary variables. For example, marital status. There are two options are provided, married and unmarried, coded as 1 and 2. Then married option again classified into three categories: widow, separated and divorced. Endogenous variables are those variables. These are directly influences, but without that is also be known as a mediating variables. These variables are inevitable, that is directly or indirectly influences the dependent variable. Exogenous variables are those variables. These are outside the system, not within the particular variables, together with the happening of dependent variable, but it is indirectly or confounded relationship towards the dependent variable. Latent variable and manifest variable. Latent variables are those variables which are hidden. For example, the presence of a particular quantity or any attribute that cannot be directly identified by the researcher, that can be identified with the help of an instrument or indicator. That indicators are known as manifesting variable. In this example, IQ test is one of the indicator used for analyzing the response related with the intelligence level, higher, medium and lower level. Then next is related with one of the example, reach into a particular concept. For example, rich. This is a concept. What are the indicators used for measuring the concept rich. One indicator, income. Then other one, asset of that particular individual. Then variables. This is the indicators. Then variables are treated as income, again asset in terms of total value. Total value of tangible assets. Tangible assets. Then the researcher confused about how to link this concept, indicator, then variables. How to link? The concept of rich, indicators used by researcher, income level and assets occupied by that particular individual, through these variables identified by income of that particular individual and the total value of the tangible assets. For that purpose, logical link is derived by the researcher by framing working definition. For example, income above 1 lakh or total value of the home or asset above 20 lakhs. This classic definition or regarding with the operational definition framed by the researcher for indicating this concept. Then the researcher built a theory on the basis of whether that individual come under APL category or BPL category. APL means above poverty line, then BPL means below poverty line. Okay, once the concept of interest have been identified, the researcher is interested in developing the relationship among these concepts. Then the researcher frame certain statements. These statements explaining the logical linkage, or that is between different concepts, by asserting universal phenomena between the concept. It is known as proposition. That means a linkage is connected by all these concepts, blueprint together, we frame a statement. That statement is known as proposition. For example, we might propose that treating our employees better, that will make them more loyal employees. This is a concept and a proposal made by the HR manager. This is certainly a logical linkage between the particular actions. One is managerial action and other one employee reaction. That is, treating our employee is a managerial action. How to treat them in better manner? What is the reaction from the side of employee? They are more loyal towards the organization. Okay, this made not really testable. It is only in general term that we call it as proposition. So the researcher use certain concept for developing tentative assumptions about the population. It is known as hypothesis. Okay, what is hypothesis? Formal statement of an unproven proposition. Proposition only statement, it is connecting a different concept, then logically linkage is framed by the researcher. That is empirically testable. That linkage, logical linkage, is testable through framing hypothesis. That is called it as hypothesis, is empirically testable one. So the difference between proposition and hypothesis. Proposition is based on abstract level. It's an abstract idea about a particular concept. Then hypothesis is based on empirical level. For example, one of the proposition, turnover intention is an inverse function of organizational commitment, especially for workers who have higher job satisfaction. Once more, the proposition one framed by a researcher, turnover intention, TI, denoted as turnover intention. Then another variable, OC, organization commitment, then job satisfaction. The proposition two is also framed by the researcher in another way. turnover intention is an inverse function of job satisfaction, especially for workers who have organizational commitment. Then how to develop a theory? These are the concepts. The number of variables identified by the researcher for the purpose of building a theory. So the researcher keep in mind the concept, indicators were used for measuring this concept, whether the concept are directly observable or indirectly observable. When it is indirectly observable one, we call it as construct. Okay, the theoretical construct of work exhaustion. Work exhaustion means job burnout. That is related to job stress, is influenced by workload, that is perceived workload, then job autonomy, work family conflict, and also one of the other variable, fairness of reward. Once more, that is the turnover intention, we call it as work exhaustion. That means job burnout. It is related to job stress. What are the other factors influencing job stress? Perceived workload. Then job autonomy. Work-family conflict. Fairness of reward. These are the variables you identified from the review of literature. Okay. Then the researcher reach into a particular development of theory. How to develop a theory? Turnover intention is a function of work exhaustion, then organizational commitment, then other independent variables also affecting. Work-family conflict, it may be due to one of the independent variable, that is marital status, then age of the employee is also affected, then total work experience. Then work exhaustion is a function of perceived workload, then fairness of reward, job autonomy and work family conflict. Then another theory is developed by researcher, organizational commitment. How to define organizational commitment by different concept or through these variables? Organizational commitment is also one of the function of job autonomy, work family conflict, then fairness of reward, then work experience, or that is mean come under the category of work exhaustion. These are the variables used as an indicator for developing a theory. Then the researcher built a model for defining turnover intention in an organization. Okay. Then the last, the framework of theory. Theory built it. Theory has been built at two levels. One is abstract level and empirical level. Abstract level is also known as conceptual level. We heard about the term theoretical framework. Then some others are called as abstraction or conceptual model developed by the researcher for defining a particular concept. Theory may be developed with the deductive reasoning. There are two types of logical reasoning. One is deductive reasoning and other one inductive reasoning. At the abstract level, the researcher develops a theory by use his or her logical reasoning. That reasoning is called as deductive reasoning. By going from what is deductive reasoning? General statement to specific assertion. For example, we know that all business professors are human beings. Once more, the statement, all business professors are human beings. If we also know that Barry Babin is a business professor, then we can deduce that Barry Babin is a human being. This is the process of reaching to a particular phenomena from general to specific. This logic is only come under theoretical framework. That is, theory is developed by the researcher on the basis of two levels. One is abstract level and other one empirical level. Then what is empirical level? Theory may be developed with the help of a reasoning. That type of reasoning is known as inductive reasoning. Inductive reasoning is a logical process of deriving the general proposition on the basis of observation. All business professors that have ever been seen are human beings. This is a particular statement. All business professors that have ever been seen are human beings. Therefore, we reach into a particular conclusion. All business professors are human beings. This is empirically proved by the researcher through observation or from experience. Okay? Thank you.